war never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war. War never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Hey, my turn, big guy.
Every time I see that face, I fall in love with you all over again.
Ah, good morning, Mum. Your coffee.
Thanks, Codsworth.
Of course, Mum.
We were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
And now for a brief look at the local reasonably warm. Temperatures continue with a high of 56.
Never gonna find that dog. Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
Looking in on next week's forecast, we have a high of 52 on Monday. But also appear our troops stationed overseas are experiencing some unusual
weather. Hey, hun.
Can't believe it's almost Halloween. Need to finish making Sean's costume.
The nights are cold, unseasonably so for sale.
It's that salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Then I'm glad I opened the door.
Oh, me too. You have no idea. Now I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see. Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments. Hun?
Wow.
Sean
look at you.
Has been changed.
Not a guy like me ever gets so lucky.
Refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection you seem to be so good at.
Go ahead, honey. I'll be there in a second to help, okay? My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile on his crib the other day. Why don't you give it a spin? My boy, on his best behavior, just like his dad. Well, most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation. We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate. you don't get
in. I'm going in. You can't stop me. I'm reporting this.
Not in the vault program.
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant? Adult male? Adult female? Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck, sir.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now, step on the platform, in the center.
All right, that's it. Shut it down.
Almost there. Is Sean okay?
He's fine. We're going to be okay. I love you.
Oh, my God!
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please, step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No.
We'd all be.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there. We'll get everyone through this as quickly as possible. Just head up the stairs.
Well, okay. Pick up a suit right over there.
Here you are. Head down the hallway.
Those are good.
Right over there.
Please, keep moving. Up the stairs and through the door.
Vault 10 is here for you.
Down the hall.
Just this way. All new residents, please proceed in an orderly
fashion. Male and infant. Good.
Welcome home.
Over there. Take a seat.
One vault.
Just step over.
Now just head down the hall. Each of you take one of these. Your brand new vault suits.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See?
It's down the hallway right there.
This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C. Oh, God, honey. What if they didn't make it?
I know this is a... difficult time, but Vault-Tec will be with you every step of the way. You'll thrive here.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
It's a good fit.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on. The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go. At least we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence. must vacate immediately.
Roaches? What the hell?
Thank you.
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back.
Thank you. live and breathe.
Codsworth.
Mum, just tending the garden, Mum. Though it is hard to be a green thumb when you lack the requisite digit, I'm afraid.
Codsworth, you're... still here. So, other people could still be alive, too.
Well, of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you have seen the worst for wear. Best not let the hubby see you in that state, huh? Where is Sir, by the way?
He's... in a better place.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Oh, Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. And I'm gonna find him. I'm gonna get my baby back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Doesn't matter how long it's been. I feel fine.
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Mum, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing. And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car, how do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left Captain Sutton. I did find this holotape.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry. Uh-huh. Shall we search the neighborhood?
Right. All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, Mum. This should be fun. Ouch. In another house. Follow me.
Hey, Codsworth.
Mum, Sir and young Sean, they aren't here. You can't give up, Mum. What about the city? Concord is nearby and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
Thanks for your help, Codsworth.
Good luck, Mum. You'll find young Sean. I know you. I shall remain here and secure the home.
Thank you.
boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself? You want to come with me, pal? Okay, then.
Up here, on the balcony. I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please!
No reason ahead.
I'm coming in there, and I'm gonna skin every last one of you!
Come on, man, they ain't... Huh? You're mine now, rookie!
man, I don't...
God damn it.
Glad to help.
Well, if that's true, we could use some more goodwill. As you can see, we're in a bit of a mess here.
Nah, that ain't it.
Please, go on.
A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. First, it was the ghouls in Lexington, and now this mess.
Sorry. Sounds really rough.
Thanks. It's good to meet someone who really cares. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
That ain't it.
One good idea can make all the difference.
Sturgis, tell her.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school. Pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
I like it.
Yeah, I thought you might. Protection with an added bonus. Get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Minigun. Now we're talking.
I know, right? Only there's one hitch. The suit's out of juice. Probably been dry for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
I'll help if I can.
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. And we know right where to find one.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate. Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
Actually, I already grabbed the fusion core. We're set.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor and grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
Careful, kid.
Excellent.
There's something.
You're with the rescue team?
And it's angry.
We got somebody up here!
easy, Mama. You okay?
I'm fine, Justin. Quit fussing.
Hey.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
The feeling's mutual, Preston.
You can never have too many friends. Not in the Commonwealth. Listen, when we first met, you said you were glad to help. Well, you did. And we owe you our lives. So here. It ain't much, but it's the best way I can say thank you.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Well, since you say that, maybe you'll come to Sanctuary with us. We could use your help getting settled there.
All right, Garvey. I'm in.
Oh, that's wonderful. But there's more to your destiny, isn't there? I've seen it. And I know your pain.
Please, tell me. I need to know.
You're a woman out of time, out of hope. But all is not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
I knew it. Please, tell me where he is. I need to find my son.
I can't see him. Not clearly, but I feel his life force. He's out there. And even I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Diamond City. The biggest settlement around.
Please, Mama Murphy. I'm working from nothing. I need more.
Look, kid. I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The site will paint a clearer picture.
No. Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk. It's...
Hey.
Oh, shush, don't worry. Preston. We're all gonna die
I'll
eventually.
Get these people to Sanctuary.
We're gonna need the site. My friend here, she's gonna...
Hi.
Hey, good to see you again. I was hoping you'd show up. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
Yeah. I used to like living here. Before the war.
What do you mean? Before what war? Are you saying...
I lived here. Over 200 years ago. I was frozen or something for most of it. Just woke up a little while ago.
Damn. Like one of those old pre-war ghouls. You say you were frozen. Anybody else make it out with you?
Just my son. Somebody took him away while I was still trapped. I've been looking for him.
Damn. I'm sorry. I hope you find him. Let me know if there's any way I can help. Anyway, I am glad you're here. And I hope you don't mind, but I've got another favor to ask. I've had word from a settlement asking for help. There's still hope in their Minutemen out there, somewhere. The only chance to start rebuilding the Minutemen is to show people that they can count on us when they need us. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you could go help out the settlement?
I'd be glad to help.
That's fantastic. The Minutemen could use more people like you. By the way, if you want to help out around here at all, talk to Sturgis. I'm sure he'd be glad for all the help he can get.
Seems to be growing well.
me know if you want something.
Excuse me.
My armor saved many a wastelander.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Focus on stopping power. Pretty, don't stop bullets.
Hey there.
What do you want? We don't need any more trouble around here.
It's okay. I'm with the Minutemen. I'm here to help.
You're with the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing traitors, but honestly, I never expected anything to come of it. Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days after Quincy. Bad business, that.
We're rebuilding the Minutemen from the ground up. We're the good guys again.
Glad to hear it. No question that things have been worse since the Minutemen fell to pieces. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks, stealing food and supplies, threatening to kill us all if we don't pony up. We know where they're coming from, but we can't go up against a gang like that.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
Thanks, friend. If you folks are for real this time, it'll be a welcome change for the better.
up, you're dead.
Austin! Spread out!
tongue tied, asshole!
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
find those raiders?
Yeah, I took care of them.
No kidding. That's the best piece of news we've had around here for a good long time. So we've been talking. We decided if you came through for us, we'd join up with the Minutemen again. If we want things to get better, we've got to start helping each other. So, we're in. You can count on us if you need help down the line. Thanks again, friend.
Yeah?
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the job. By the way, you should have one of these flare guns. You can use it to signal for help from any nearby Minutemen. Not much use yet, but once we have more Allied settlements, you'll have help whenever you need it. I don't think I ever told you what happened to them. How I ended up with the last one.
I figured you'd tell me when you were ready.
Have you heard of the Quincy Massacre?
No.
I thought everyone in the Commonwealth knew about that by now. Where the Minutemen betrayed each other and the people they were supposed to protect. I was with Colonel Hollis's group. A mercenary group called the Gunners was attacking Quincy. The people there called for the Minutemen to help. We were the only ones that came. The other groups, they just turned their backs on us and the folks in Quincy. Only a few of us got out alive. Colonel Hollis was dead, so I ended up in charge of the survivors. We never found a safe place to settle. One disaster after another. You saw how it ended in Concord?
As long as you don't give up, the Minutemen will survive.
I'm not about to give up, but I can't protect the Commonwealth all by myself. Hell, I could barely protect these people. That's why I'm talking to you. I can't rebuild the Minutemen, but I think you can.
That means a lot coming from you, Garvey.
I appreciate that. Does that mean you'll do it?
Okay. I'll do it.
Good. Good. Welcome aboard. I feel like this is a whole new start for the Minutemen, and the Commonwealth, too. Don't worry. I'll be right beside you all the way, General.
That's quite a promotion you just gave me.
The leader of the Minutemen has always held the rank of General. Our last leader was General Becker. After he died back in 82, nobody could agree on who should take his place. The one good thing about being the last Minuteman is, there's no one to argue with me when I say you're the new General. Now it's your job to make it more than an empty title. I've got something a bit different for you. Our scouts have found a promising spot for a new settlement. The trouble is that some kind of vicious beasts are lairing there. Once you clear it out, set up a radio beacon to let settlers know about it. Before you know it, we'll have a thriving new farm instead of wasteland. We'll take back the Commonwealth, one piece at a time.
sweet. I cleared out that spot you sent me to and set up a radio beacon there.
That's great news. Once folks have some place to call their own, they'll be willing to help defend it. As usual, I have something else for you to look into. I'll mark it on your map. We'll find out what they need. We need more settlements supporting our cause. Wait. Something's out there.
Let's go, motherfucker!
Did the Minutemen send you?
Yes, I'm here to help. What's going on?
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies. Threatening us if we can't give them what they want. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand up to them ourselves.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
I hope so. We didn't know what to do.
So that's it, huh?
Thank you.
Thank you.
I took care of those raiders for you.
Really? Well, that's the best news I've heard in a long time. By the way, we've talked about it, and we've decided to support the Minutemen. I think it's worth giving it another chance. The only way things will get better is if we stand together.
What do you need, General?
I took care of the raiders that were harassing that settlement you sent me to. The people there have decided to join our cause.
That's great news.
One day, we'll be strong enough to drive that scum out of the Commonwealth for good. As usual, I've got something else for you to look into. We've gotten big enough that we're having trouble communicating with all our settlements. It's a good problem to have, and I have a solution. I think it's time to retake the castle. It used to be the Minutemen HQ, way before my time. Well fortified, centrally located, and...
Excuse me.
Do you think we're ready to retake the castle?
Yeah, let's do this.
We'll do some recon and meet you outside the castle. See you there.
Thank you.
deal, Trudy. Hand over the goods. You owe us.
I ain't giving you poison shilling chem pushers anything. Do you know what that junk has done to my boy?
He bought them fair and square, Trudy. Ain't our fault if he's strung out. Now don't make me come in there and shoot up that little trading post of yours. Whoa, easy then. That's right.
Excuse me.
Walk away.
We're closed. You can thank that poison cellar outside for that.
Anything I can do to help?
Why? You for hire? I have 100 caps if you blow Wolfgang's head off.
Your offer seems a little low for a man's life.
Fair enough. Say 125 caps.
All right, Trudy. I'll get rid of him.
Thank you. I'll back you up from here. Go get him. Look at all the blood. I can't wait to see the crows feeding on that scumbag.
Sure. Let's take a look.
All salvage, but nothing's junk.